Greetings and welcome back, everybody, to the Satanic Media Agenda Exposed with Michael in Germany. Today we are on the rock band Kiss, and it is a rather interesting discussion we have because, I don't think Michael, I was never into this group when I was young, but I think you may have been a little bit, but I don't think you really are one of their big fans, are you, Michael?
Hello, Brett, and hello, dear listener. Thanks for having me. Another episode of the Satanic Media Exposed. Now we're into Kiss once again. I must admit, I had 6 or 7 long play records of them, and we in the school, we thought about of playing or imitating Kiss for a school celebration, but we weren't allowed due to the officials because they were afraid of spitting blood and making loud music, and so this whole project was stopped immediately. But I intended to be the drummer of the band, Peter Criss, because every other member of the Kiss band already was occupied, and so I was given the role of playing Peter Criss. But you see, I was 13 at the age of 13, so please excuse
it's,
my
it's a day. Rough age, isn't it? Yes.
Yeah, please excuse my lack of experience there, because I found something cool, and if you are not that smartest guy in the school, which I wasn't, so I thought that this whole system sucks, and so I have to make some protest, and I thought about kids with wearing masks would be a great idea. Okay. Nevertheless, we started.
We can call this childish thinking, Michael.
Yeah. Yeah, of course, we didn't know
easily. Yeah, 13 years old. This is normal.
Did by far better than us. You see, everybody has their faults and their teenage rampage days.
This rock group is not normal. No.
Yeah, at least they are being publicly sold as some kind of heroes, or sold some kind of outraging guys, which they aren't. You see that in the last episode, we have shown a video with the drunken Ace Frehley in a television show, and it seems like a childish birthday party or whatever, but these are no serious musicians in the case that they are really having something to say other than to perform and to proceed with the Satanic Media Agenda. It's just all an agenda, and they're part of the agenda because they came up with the great idea to put masks on their face and to make pyrotechnical efforts, spitting blood, raising themselves up, flying through the air, all these things in the 70s where they are famous for. There's Kiss is famous for being a live band, for the audience, for the Kiss Army, for the events surrounding the group Kiss, for the whole phenomenon, but not for the sheer amount of songs. It's just a handful who are decent in my humble opinion nowadays. But you see, it's no better or worse than any other rock group mentioned. So what has a musician like Gene Simmons or Gene Klein or Eugene Klein or Shane Witz, his actual name, has to do in front, standing in front in the before the audience in the Pentagon in Washington? Please explain that to me. And you see that if you search that, you will find that he's part of an initiative to promote military activities. He's not the smiling nice guy, Mr. Nice Guy, he isn't. So he solves his problems with the army, and he's one of the founding members of KISS, and KISS members or KISS fans are called KISS Army. So they solve their problems by having a fight, not having an argument, but having a fight. So on the totally unchristian way. And interesting that they have invited him to be a part of that initiative, haven't they? So what's a actor and a singer has to do with the Pentagon? I thought it was a serious ministry of or a Department of Defense. But actually, it turns out that they are making promotion here or propaganda. Because, you see, he's a very known figure in the United States of America and or worldwide. So to make promotion for the Pentagon, which he does, he has first to be signalizing that he's in line with the American Constitution because he's living in America. And as far as I know, he's got American citizenship. Citizenship, I think it's a correct name. Okay. Therefore, we have just here, we can insert a video from the actual speech he did, telling you that he's been born in the promised land, but actually America is the promised land and not Israel. How interesting. So please take a look at this.
I may have been born in the country, everybody. Give me 2 seconds. I may have been born in the country that people throughout history have referred to as the promised land, but take my word for it. America is the promised land for everybody. And don't be ashamed, don't hesitate. We need to teach young people to be comfortable with saying, God bless America. End of my story.
Gene Simmons telling us that America is the promised land instead of Israel. Well, why does he claim that? Because he's not a real or a reborn Christian, actually. He's been born being a Jew. We have learned 2 or 3 episodes before. And actually, he's feeling home in Israel today or some years ago, because there is another video circling around with him. Speaking of Israel being his home. So please compare the second video to the first one we have shown already.
Insert second video here.
Okay, so now we got a little bit of contradiction, because the Bible tells us that Moses has led his people out of the captivity from Egypt to the so-called promised land, which was happened to be somewhere north or northeast of Egypt, or so-called Israelites have settled there 2,000 whatever year ago, more than 2,000 years ago, far more than 2,000 years ago. And now Gene Simmons, as known as Chaimwitz, now telling us that America is a promised land. This is, of course, not in line with the Bible, but I think that he thought that it would be a great idea to sell the people that he's American guy and not limited to his origin of being a Jew. And so I think this is a little bit of contradiction, because first point, he's not in line with the Bible, and the second point is that I don't see at all that America should be the promised land, not with that many flaws in it, and not also with the thing that Gene Simmons, of course, is one of the merchants of the earth, making big profit and making big money since he went to America. So for him, actually, individually, America, of course, is a promised land, because he can sell all his stuff, all his books about hookers, etc., in America. So that's for him, it's a promised land. And so that whoever pays him or to ever ask him out, he will share his opinion to those with those who pay him, because he is one of the merchants of the earth. That's at least my point of view in that concern. I don't know if Brett can agree on that.
Oh, yeah, most certainly. And not only that, But Michael, he's also he's also a very poor actor, because in that first video, he stumbles. It sounds like he's almost going to cry some crocodile tears or something there, right? Mm-hmm. Before he mm-hmm. makes his statement. And in the Pentagon, I mean, this is the Pentagon, you know, I mean, it's really bad acting, but the people mm-hmm. buy it. Oh, yep.
You know? Yeah, yes. So he has to claim that because he's American citizen, and he makes money, and he's making a living in America and not in Israel.
Yeah, so yeah, that's right. So it's the promised land to him for
to
sure.
Him,
It's the place where he can go and rape and pillage and no problem. Hey, everyone, you know, fornication's great in America.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Hey, yeah, just great. I can get away with all this and no problem. You know, people love it.
Yeah, but you see that the problem I got is if the Pentagon is for real. We all know that. It's called the Department of Defense or something like that. Yeah, so why did they use Gene Simmons instead of someone who has a good reputation? You see that Gene Simmons, okay, I know that Forbes magazine has granted him a Lifetime Achievement Award, but for what, actually? For having sex with more than 4,000 women or what?
Probably. You
see, yeah, you see that it's such a mess. It's such a mess having a frontman of KISS. You see that in the times when KISS were real threat to all the parents in America and worldwide in the 70s. No one would ever have imagined that 40 years later, a so-called Gene Simmons standing in front of the Pentagon, giving a speech, they would have thought... If
yeah,
you have told the people 40 or 50 years ago that 40 years later, the frontman of KISS making a speech at the Pentagon.
I think it's clear to everyone, Michael, the old world is no longer what this world
yeah.
is.
Yeah.
It's completely changed.
Yeah,
and
the world
slowly,
has changed,
too.
Huh?
It's not a quick change. It's a very slow and a very subtle change.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you know that in German we got a phrase for that that's called salami tactic. Yeah, so like like having, for example, a piece of not a complete cheese, but a part of it or slice of it, and one slice and one slice and one slice. So you're making progress. You're making progress. You're undermining the morality. Yeah, you show naked breast, then you show a naked breast, then show a naked behind, et cetera,
yeah,
et cetera. And,
exactly.
and then go to full nudity from behind, et cetera, et cetera. And one thing in line with that, and a little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit more. And then people get used to it, think that it's usual, quite normal.
Oh, yeah. And now we can legalize drugs in America because, hey, everyone does it anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Legalize marijuana is what I want to say.
Yeah,
you know?
Okay, I didn't know that. Mm-hmm.
Well, it's not necessarily the case. But look, I mean, it used to be the war on drugs, right?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that was the reality that we grew up with as youngsters here in America. I'm not sure about Europe, Michael.
Mm-hmm.
But here in the United States, it was the war on drugs, you know, back in the 80s and 90s and then now it warped into the war on terror. And who's the terrorist, Michael?
Mm-hmm.
Well, it depends on which side of the spiritual fence you're on.
Mm-hmm.
Are you on the side of the flesh or are you on the side of the spirit? And have you been born again or not? So it's really quite complicated. It's not simple.
Actually, it would be simple if people would be in the spirit of the Holy Spirit, of course. But
yeah, that's exactly
as the majority of the people aren't aware of any spiritual being at all, and they believe themselves to be God, that they believe themselves they're being under no way under some kind of judgment or to obey someone or something. You see, that's
right. That's a perfect point, Michael. And you know, we're trained in a heliocentric system of science, and if you don't comply with a heliocentric system, well, then you're a conspiracy theorist. And I'm sorry, but I believe in a geocentric system because I'm a born again Bible believer. The earth is the footstool of Jesus Christ, right? So the earth is his footstool, not the sun. But yet the whole carnal world revolves around the sun. So when you become a born again creature, everything changes. Your whole structure changes. It's not quickly either. It's slow. It takes a long time to discern exactly how spiritual the Spirit of God works with you when you allow him some space to do the job that he needs to do inside of you. Because we are the temple of the Most High. We are each individual that has a relationship with Christ. So it's kind of complicated. It's not really that simple in the sense that the world wants a carnal system. They require carnal people like this man right here to worship. They worship him. They actually worship this man. And this man praises Satan, right, Michael? It's obvious. And here he is at the Pentagon saying, God bless America. This is the promised land. Yeah, it's way off. Way off. He's
once
deceiving
again,
the people.
The name God has no copyright. There is no copyright for the name of God. G-O-D. Could be anything.
Could be Gene Simmons.
Could, yeah, it could be the great orchestra of Dawn, G-O-D, could be anything, could mean anything. Yeah, it's not necessarily the thing that most people would...
could be the flag with the golden trim edge. Right there. Yeah,
golden edge, yes.
That has a special meaning. That golden edge has a special meaning, that's right, Michael. And you know what that special meaning is, don't you?
Yeah, I think I know that, yes.
It's a maritime flag. That means that that our country has, what is it, like 1930-something. We've been under maritime law since the 30s. And that's what that flag represents. We can look it up. Boy, I mean, you know, it's trouble. It's real trouble.
Yeah, you could also ask, but why has the Pentagon five walls? Why is it a Pentagon anyway? I think you could find it out for yourself if you listen often to the Satanic Media Exposed. I don't think that we have to supply the answer to you, because I would love to see the general audience being a partaker of the series by having their own thoughts about the subjects presented here. Okay, but moving on now from Gene Simmons telling us that America was the promised land, actually. Moving on now, this is the Pentagon, once again. Interesting architecture. And this small little house here inside.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah. Oh, I would love to see...
What year was that done?
I would love to see what's going on there. Yeah.
Weird. What year was that from?
I don't know.
Wow. I really don't know. Strange.
I don't know. You see that in these days, there are so many things photoshopped.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Yeah.
It looks like dirty laundry outside, I think. I don't know.
Yeah, that's right. It's probably photoshopped,
if that's real or not. You see that in these last days or last hours, as we said before, you see, you cannot reckon on anything. You have to be so careful. Oh, I don't know. I think I remember why I put that pentagram in here. But just
Hey, everybody, I was wrong. It's not maritime. It's Admiralty.
Admiralty, okay.
Admiralty on the fringe, the gold fringe of the U.S. flag. So, yeah. Okay. Sorry about that.
Yeah, no problem. I just moved on. Yeah, you see that. No? Gene Simmons gives Pentagon briefing. Yeah, you see this some kind of reference to the lightning bolt, Luke 10:18. Behold, I saw Satan fall like a lightning from sky. Yeah, it's always the same reference. And why did I put that here in the Gene Simmons Kiss script? Oh, I have to think about that. That some months ago, I think half a year ago, I did that. Oh, you see that. Oh, 2019, Gene Simmons gives Pentagon briefing. Yeah, I think you will come up with that on your own. Yeah. He's a trustworthy man, huh? You would love to see him take care of your daughter and son, huh? Yeah, Chain paying homage to the Indian goddess of Kali by sticking his tongue out. I got a different opinion about that. I can still also say that Chain paying homage to the serpent by sticking his tongue out.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. But anyway, Gene Simmons fight back tears, talking how much his late mother loved America. Yes, we will not go into that. Yeah, because it's so obvious with Gene Simmons, you see, that it's blatant obvious. Jesus. It's blatant obvious.
Oh, yeah, it is. It's too obvious.
It's too obvious, actually. Yeah. Okay. And he tells you what you want to hear, because here in this interview, he says that he's a fan of the German Chancellor Angela Merkel. And if the Chancellor would change in Germany, he would be a fan of the new Chancellor also. So he does everything for his publicity, that he's coming out as the one who's in line, in accordance to the ruling elite. That's his ultimate goal, to make money and to have...
Look at his hat!
Yeah, I know.
Too obvious is right.
It's too obvious.
What's on that hat? It's a black hat with a white bag of...
Yeah.
What?
It could be a dollar sign. Could be anything.
I think it's a dollar sign, Michael.
Yeah. Yeah. So my interpretation is not far-fetched, isn't it?
No. Not at all.
Okay.
Straight up.
Okay, so in this video now, which we can show now, this is a video session, I think, we show you that blood is thicker than hummus by pointing out, look at the kippah here, some kind of kippah, I think, of the Jewish hat on Gene Simmons, who speaks fluently Hebrew. Did you know that?
No.
At least you can watch that if we make this insert now.
What's the name of this video, Michael?
Blood is thicker than hummus. If you don't have it already, I can send it to you. Anyway, there's a YouTube link I can send you also. So
okay, we cut YouTube. That here, and then we go back to our discussion. I haven't seen this one yet, so.
Okay. The next video is Gene Simmons visiting Rambam. Huh? What's Rambam? You see, that's the hospital where he's supposed to have been born in, I don't remember, I have to look it up, I think 1947 or something like that. So he is going back to the place of his birth. And there's a very interesting interview, because pretending that he's the alpha male and he's the ultimate challenge and he's the bad guy, the evil guy, then the staged conversation took place, because then he's been talking about he's a male even though he wears high heels and makeup. And I found that so hilarious, funny, that I would like to watch that together with the audience, because then you get a little bit more interesting picture of who Gene Simmons actually is or pretends to be. So this is, I think, the last video insert for this session. Okay, this was then Gene Simmons, and he's been born on the 5th of August, 1949, according to my smartphone, which I have to use because I'm sharing screen at the moment. Okay, so now you know that he's a proper male and he has made such horrible numbers. We could also send you another video. of him claiming to have sex with more than 4,000 women, but I think you can find it out for yourself by simply search engine use of YouTube. So the question arises, what is the agenda of Gene Simmons? As if we didn't know that already. But you see that to point the things really down to the nitty-gritty, KISS has been promoted as the hottest band of the world. You see, to create heat, usually you have to burn something. And that's why KISS also says they are not only the hottest band in the world, but hotter than hell. So it's so obvious. It's so obvious that they actually belong to the dark side, or they belong to the lake of fire, actually, because hell has not been mentioned in the Bible. And in that regard, as the Roman Catholic Church wants you to believe in heaven or hell, but it's actually the lake of fire. And it's in Revelation 21:8, where it's been speaking about the lake who's been burning of fire and brimstone. This is the second death. More disgusting images of Mr. Chambitz. You see this I love you Satan sign. You see the pentagram. You see the downward facing pyramid, etc., etc. We don't have to go into that very deep because you see that this is some kind of reference to the gender agenda. Paul Stanley trying to look like a femme fatale or something like that with the with his dress and with his lipstick
black and red.
So question,
pentagrams.
Why do people always believe that KISS is supposed to mean knights in Satan's service? A knights in Satan's service. This is a documentary. But there is no substance. There is no proof for that. You know, people think that it's KISS, Knights in Satan Service. But my point is that it's just a rumor. Rumor has it, but it doesn't. Not because the website does deny it, because that I doubt that knights would wear high heels. Of course, they are equipped with their weapons, being their mouth and being their instruments, but knights usually don't wear high heels. And I doubt that this group is so smart and that they will lead you astray on the wrong path. And so we are going down the right path. So this is an internet found of Mr. Gene Wilder himself, I think, being a Jew also. It's a famous actor. So tell me again how KISS can stand for Knights in Satan's Service, but you have two Jews, a Lutheran and a Catholic in the band. I don't know which lineup he is speaking about, and I don't know if I can back up that claim. But the thing is that KISS never officially pointed out that they are Knights in Satan's Service. Of course, they are in Satan's service, but could it be that this means something else? Yeah, you see, with these boots, you can hardly fight. Yeah, it's a fight, a struggle to put them on and to walk with them, but it's futile to say that they are really knights and they fight for each other. So this is a German episode of what a knight actually is. Yeah. And you see, the KISS, KISS, has a long history in Judaism. It is closely linked with the handling and learning of Torah. Jews often kiss a Torah scroll, which is what this woman here appears seems to be, seems to make. Jews often kiss a Torah scroll when it is brought into the congregation. People will kiss a chumash or siddur that has been dropped. Students would kiss the hand of their master after a learning session, symbolically acknowledging the hand that fed them spiritually sustenance. Yeah. Okay. So, the kiss is a spiritual act and has a long history in Judaism. Please remember that at least Chaimwitz, better known as Gene Simmons, is wearing a kippah in one of the videos. And he claims that Israel is his home, which we have seen in the second video. So, what's it about? Because you see that the Judaism talks about their master, and it's about the Judaism comes actually, or the pagan Judaic Kabbalah, it's a system, comes actually from the captivity in Babylon. So in Matthew 23, it has been called that there is no master but Jesus Christ. But they are talking about their master. That is the first small hint. But I got something more. In the highest heaven, the angels who serve before the throne of glory kiss God during the afternoon worship. That's called Hichalot Rabati. The special category of kiss is the kiss of God, Mechta Benishika in Hebrew, or Mise Benishike in Yiddish. This refers to death directly at the hands of God or the Shekinah. 930 kinds of death were created in the world. The most difficult is plague. The easiest of all is a kiss. Plague is like burr being pulled through a wool fleece, or like stalks in your throat. A kiss is as gentle as drawing a hair out of milk. The concept arises from the death of Moses, where it is said he died al pi Adonai, at God's command, but literally by God's mouth, Deuteronomy 34. This is the fifth book of Moses, chapter 34, verse 5. I think we should cite that or quote that from the King James Bible, right?
Oh, sure. Let me see.
So Deuteronomy 34:5.
Okay. So Moses, the servant of the Lord, died there in the land of Moab, according to the word of the Lord.
Yeah. So the belief of Judaism, or the Zohar book, is that God has commanded Moses with a kiss from God, by God's mouth, not by the word of God, but by God's mouth, to die, actually. So, and this is a contradiction to the Bible, because in the Bible, Brett has clearly stated that the death arose by the word of God, correct? Mm-hmm. By the word of the Lord, and not by the mouth of the Lord. So by speaking, everything is created by, and God said, as we have learned in the last episode, last session, and God can also end the life by simply putting out the breath of life of someone, or simply making a speech or saying that now the time has been passed, or the time is come at hand. I don't know the correct English phrase for that. Please forgive me for my bad English again. According to the Jewish tradition, the easiest of all deaths circumvents the dreaded angel of death. According to the sage, only six people have died this way. This is a sage. This is not the truth. This is traditional Judaism from the, I think, from the Zohar. This is not in line with the teachings of the Bible. So according to the so-called sages, only six people have died that way: Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Miriam, Aaron, and Moses. In later Jewish mystical writings, a number of Kabbalistic masters die in ecstasy via the kiss. Jewish mysticism also equated the kiss with devikot, mystical fusion with God. And the Zohar is one of the profound writings of the Kabbalah, which is coming originally from Babylon, Mesopotamia, Nimrod, Semiramis, Tammuz. This is all of the Gnostic teaching against the word of God in the Holy Bible. This is also the content, or some of the contents, which the so-called Knights Templar have been informed or initiated with during the Crusades, and they got back to Europe serving Baphomet. That's why the general of the Knights Templar, Jacques de Molay, was then executed in front of the inside of the Notre Dame, where he was facing the Baphomet on the Notre Dame. And so this whole Jewish tradition goes back, as I said before, to Babylon. And the Book of Zohar means the Book of what's it in English? The Book of the Shining One, or the Book of let me translate that quickly here in English. The Book of Shine. Yeah, the Book of Shine, and it goes back to biblical scriptures from the prophet Ezekiel and Daniel, so called. But it mixes the holy with the profane, obviously. And this is here from Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. Okay, it's very complicated to translate that back from English and German and German and English and to get the meaning of it. But you see, this is these are scriptural texts in a ritual. Yeah, it's a Zohar, it's a book of shine. And they think that God ends the life by kissing someone. And now, please put that in context with the name of the group, KISS. If you put in perspective that Gene Simmons is of Jewish origin, then he believes in the so-called kiss of death. That's most likely. I cannot prove that, of course, but it's most likely, because he makes all that satanic stuff on stage, putting the tongue out, spitting fire, having that dragon mask on, etc., dragon wings, especially. Paul Stanley, the same, Ace Reilly, the same, all the guys are making propaganda for Satan. I think we can agree on that, Brett.
Yeah,
but that's right. Now think again, if they are making propaganda for Satan, whom they are mocking. Because Satan is just the name for being the adversary. So they have to mock the real Almighty God. And that's why I came up with the Gene Simmons on Powell.
Oh, that's where that little logo comes from on his hat.
Yeah, okay.
I see.
So, Gene Simmons, I get it. On power, or more power. So, he's into the material world. Okay. Who is in charge in this world for all materialistic things, especially money? For the love of money is the root of all evil. 1 Timothy 6:10. But who's in charge of all the money? Who's in charge of the supply? Who's in charge of all the materialistic things, of all the kingdoms and their glory? I think here comes Luke chapter 4, verse 4 to 7 in account. This is from memory. I think that Brett can...
Luke chapter 4.
Chapter 4, yes, and then verse 4, or starting with verse 1 to 7 or 8.
Okay. And Jesus, being full of the Holy Spirit, returned from Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, being 40 days tempted of the devil. And in those days he did eat nothing. And when they were ended, he afterward hungered. And the devil said unto him, If thou be the Son of God, command this stone that it be made bread. And Jesus answered him, saying, It is written that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word of God. And the devil, taking him up into a high mountain, showed him the kingdoms of the world in a moment of time. And the devil said unto him, All this power I will give thee, and the glory of them, for it is delivered unto me, and to whomsoever I will give it. If thou therefore wilt worship me, all shall be thine.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's it.
Yep.
That's it. If you will worship me, all will be thine. All kingdoms
shall be thine. Yeah.
Yeah. All kingdoms of the world. All kingdoms and their, what is it, glory?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. And the glory of them.
Yeah. So yeah. Whom is Gene Simmons serving?
The power of the devil.
Yeah, correct.
According to scripture.
The devil is called Satan, for Satan is just the explanation, or the meaning of Satan is being the adversary. So the adversary of the Almighty God. Or the adversary of Jesus Christ.
Ooh, can I just add a little something?
Yeah, sure.
It's Gene Simmons on power over slavery, because remember, the debt notes are mm-hmm. slavery mm-hmm. for everyone. We've all been enslaved by the system of lies. And Gene Simmons is promoting this system of lies and power over slavery, making others subject to Satan.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So it's full circle.
Yeah. Yeah, it must be, you see. The thing is that it must be, because if we look up all the Bible quotes, then you will see that this kingdom of Christ is a spiritual kingdom, it's not of this world. So if he's looking for power on this earth, he must be in line with Satan, because he's looking for power now and more power. And it has all to do with materialistic things, because he's claiming it that power is money, or money is power. You see, power is in accordance to...
What's the subtitle of that book? I can't read it.
What is it? Me neither.
Can you zoom in again? What was it again?
Yeah, try.
Yeah. Oh, boy, that's really hard to read. I'll look it up while you're talking.
Yeah, you can.
I will.
Yeah, okay. But we proceed, because we know that he's serving Satan.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why I'm quoting the Bible here. I'm quoting Judas Iscariot. And what did Judas Iscariot do?
Oh, here it is. The subtitle is My Journey mm-hmm. Through the Corridors of Power. And now you can get, and then it shows the bag of money, more power, of course. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So, yeah, go ahead, Michael. I'm sorry I interrupted.
No, but I can show you, because I got here the software ESOT, where you can read the line, which I think is most likely that it's about the group his. I have to look that up. Yeah, 2647 to 2649. Can you read it?
I sure can.
Okay.
Yep. And while he yet spake, lo, Judas, one of the 12, came, and with him a great multitude with swords and staves from the chief priests and elders of the people. Now he that betrayed him gave them a sign, saying, whomsoever I shall kiss, that same is he. Hold him fast. And forthwith he came to Jesus and said, Hail, Master, and kissed him.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's my interpretation of the meaning of the group kiss. Simple as that, because Gene Simmons is a Jew and he believes in the kiss of death. And Judas Iscariot, being one of the 12 disciples of Jesus Christ, betrayed him. So he was in the spirit of Satan. That was mentioned in the Bible also during the Last Supper when Jesus Christ spoke that one of the 12 will betray him. So it's a kiss of death. It's a kiss of betrayal. That's what actually the group kiss stands for, in my humble opinion. Betrayed with a kiss. That's all I have to say about that. It can also mean the knights in Satan's service. Of course, could it be? But in first instance, I'd say that, taking into account that he is of Jewish descendants, has Jewish roots, and in Jewish tradition, not in the Bible, but in the tradition, a kiss can mean a kiss of death, which is not in accordance with the Holy Bible. And Gene Simmons is not in accordance with the Holy Bible, because on their fruits you will know them. And look at the fruits of Gene Simmons, making fornication with thousands of women. Making propaganda for the agenda of Satan, the Satanic Media Agenda, in every kind, shape, or form. And to me, it's blatant obvious that kiss means that it's a kiss of betrayal.
Mm-hmm.
And mm-hmm. look at the mask of Gene Simmons. He's got a black lipstick. Black stands for death, the absence of light. There are so many hints for him. And you see that according to John 13:26, we can look that up here. Yeah, John 13:26 and 27. Could you read that, Brad?
Give me a second. I was looking. Oh, you're right here. Okay, John 13:26 and 27, correct?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Jesus answered, He it is to whom I shall give a sop when I have dipped it. And when he had dipped the sop, he gave it to Judas Iscariot, the son of Simon. And after the sop, Satan entered into him. Then said Jesus unto him, That thou doest, do quickly.
Yeah, Satan entered into him. And I think that both of us and most of the audience, or the majority of the audience at least, will have no doubt what kind of spirit Gene Simmons is in. So for me, it's just not that far-fetched to say that KISS is all about promoting the agenda of Satan, and it's all about the mocking of Jesus Christ. And if I name the group KISS, being a Jew myself, not accepting Jesus Christ, obviously, because look at the fruits of KISS in general, and look at the fruits of Gene Simmons also, then it's all going down. Hotter than hell. Yeah, you see, it's everywhere. You don't have to be a member of any satanic temple or a church of Satan or what else. Yeah, you don't have to. It's everywhere. He's making the signals, I love you, Satan. Can you imagine?
I got to fess up, Michael. When you asked me who this photo was yesterday, you know who I had in mind? I didn't know Kevin Spacey. Okay.
Yeah.
You know who I had in mind?
No.
Alex Jones.
Ah. Yeah, but we have shown Alex Jones also.
I know, but I mean, I just wanted to fess up because
okay.
Mm-hmm. I really didn't know much about Kevin. I don't know much about Kevin Spacey. I really don't.
Mm-hmm.
I really don't hardly know a thing about the guy.
Mm-hmm.
But he looks very similar to Alex Jones when he was younger, if you ask me. If you ask me. But that's just my opinion.
I don't have to ask you because you gave the answer before.
Right.
Now, you see, on the fruits, you will know them. Gene Simmons, I haven't slept with 4,600 women. It's 4,800. Yeah. The 62-year-old in 2011, helped to turn his face-paint-daubed rock band Kiss into a billion-dollar empire and has a personal fortune of more than 200 million pounds. That's far more than $200 million. And after ranking in cash from a host of other business ventures, Gene Simmons is not an ordinary man. Yeah, we know that, huh? They are all in the evil spirits. Yeah, 4,800 fornications. But married, huh? Of course. Yeah. What sense makes a marriage when you have such a great guy? Oh. This is sarcasm. He even explained how he can be so specific about his numbers of his fornications. I took Polaroid photos for a long time. I took photos of the vast majority. It just proves you can be an ugly and if you got the right job, you'll have access. If you're a rock star, you will get some, even if you're Lemmy, speaking of one of the members of the band Motorhead. Despite his extensive womanizing, Gene married his girlfriend of 28 years, Shannon Tweed, at the Beverly Hills Hotel on October the 1st. Gene and the former Playboy Playmate, 54, have a son, Nick, 22 years of age, and a daughter, Sophie, 19 years of age, but he's pleased he has resisted marriage until now. He says, the nature of man is to wander. Oh, Brett, there will come the book of Job 1:6 into play. You know, when the sons of God, including Satan, went to the throne of God, and God asked Satan, where comest thou? And Satan answered from...
To and fro, right?
Yeah.
From to and fro upon the earth.
Yeah.
I think it is.
Yeah, and he's speaking of here, the nature of man is to wander. Yeah. What kind of man he's talking about.
Right. Either one or the other. You're talking about the wheat or the tare,
correct.
Sheep or the goat.
Yeah, correct.
One or the other. That's it.
Yeah, he's talking such a BS here. As a species, speak of men, we don't mature until we are in our 60s. That's such a waste of time. Yeah, but you see, he's been praised as being some kind of the wealthiest merchants of the earth. Yeah, look how he's presenting himself. And it's getting worse. I pick up the phone and call Donald Trump or Richard Branson or Warren Buffett directly. Yeah, so he's an influencer. Richard Branson, I think it's the chief of Virgin Records, if I remember correctly. Warren Buffett is one of the most prolific market specialists when it comes to stocks, stock exchange, something, assets. There is a Kiss golf course in Las Vegas. The Kiss Coffee House franchises everything from Kiss condoms to Kiss casket. Well, will get you coming and will get you going. It is the first time the Drug and Food Administration in America has allowed printing on a condom. It's never been allowed before of health reasons. The very first printing on any condom ever is my face with my tongue out. Gene Simmons, 40. I'll show you there in the kiss room at my house. Do you prefer used or fresh? Ha ha ha. What a joke. What a joke. What a joke. Here are the condoms, he said. I'll give you one. We'll have about 2,000 different items of KISS merchandise in here. Nobody touches us. We outsell the Beatles and Elvis Presley. It's a billion-dollar company. We launched KISS BMWs a few months ago. We have KISS everything. Every deal is unique. Then, pointing towards a small plastic contraption, he said, now I'll show you my favorite. It goes in a urinal. You pee in it and I talk to you. They were in restaurants and everything, but now everyone has stolen them. He touched the gadget to demonstrate and Gene voice squeaks from the tiny speaker. Even my tongue is longer than that. On the fruits, you will know them.
Ah, man.
Yeah, and here are some kind of of lyrics. We have avoided to speak about the lyrics the entire time.
Oh, jeez. Oh, boy. Yeah.
We can spare it for the next episode.
It's too obvious.
Yeah, we can spare that for the next episode if you.
Sounds good. Yeah, I think we should. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Sounds good, Michael. Yeah.
Yeah, I hope you got something out of that session here. Yeah, because it's really not that far-fetched, and it's really not that... but you see that people are not getting used to make any research on their own. And also people underestimate the impact of these so-called influencers. You know, we just have learned that KISS is a billion-dollar company. They are printing their name, their logo on everything. So people, they get away with that in that world. They are being praised for being satanic, for being against Jesus Christ the Lord. If you want to make it in the world, you have to be satanic. But otherwise, you won't make it in that world. At least not the wealthy guy who's really in the business. If you are really a nice guy or a nice girl out there, which you maybe which you are by listening to that kind of sessions we are doing here, you won't make it in the material world because you're not partaker of that world outside, which is only in existence or only it's only founded on Cain, on the first murderer, and on all the sign of Marduk or the sign of Cain, and they get along with everything because they are making the rules in the world here, in this world. They are making the rules. So that's why they are so successful. And so you can either be a partaker of this world or you can look forward to the next kingdom, to the kingdom of Christ, which Brett and me are looking forward to. And so I'd like to hand it over for that session to my brother Brett, because I'm a little bit out of breath and I need to drink.
Oh, so thank you, Michael. Yeah, this is it's a good session because, well, we're looking into Gene Simmons, who is not a very good example for the Jewish people now, is he? He's really a poor example for the Jewish people. But let's look at what it means to be a carnal Jew, not a spiritual one. There's something called Kabbalah also that we didn't touch. And that if you look up the definition for Kabbalah on the most basic search on the internet, on Google, it says the ancient Jewish tradition of mystical interpretation of the Bible, first transmitted orally and using esoteric methods, including ciphers, it reached the height of its influence in the later Middle Ages and remains significant in Hasidism. I don't know what that is. I'd have to look that up. But look, when I first learned about Kabbalah, I was shocked because I was studying the Bible at the time, and I had no idea that merchants of the earth actually use Kabbalah. It's a standard practice in the industry, in the music, so-called music industry, the so-called arts. What an art. It's not what I consider good. This is very wicked. And we'll leave it at that, because everyone has to do their own research and study these things for themselves in order to find the facts. Because I get tired, Michael, of getting people leaving comments on whatever doctrine you want to put on the comment. Everyone has a time and place for doing their research and reading the Bible and studying on their own. So the point is, I offer something here on my YouTube channel that's different than most other YouTube channels is. I like to bring people on like Michael, and we dig deep into a subject, and we leave lots of space to say what needs to be said and match it up against the Bible to the best of our abilities. And not everyone's going to agree with that. It's like when you're a songwriter, which I am actually. When you write a song, there's no way you're going to make a song that's going to please everybody. It doesn't happen. You're asking way too much to write a song that'll please everybody. But, you know, in this world, here we have zoom in on Gene Simmons here. You can make a song that will please people to fornicate and to commit adultery and to be a wicked sinner. And that's praised in this world because everyone loves to disobey God's commandments. So that's the trouble. You know, it's not for me to point fingers at others and say, hey, look, you're this, this, and this. No, that's something we need to do on our own.
Jewish people in general, of course, no?
No. Of course not. Because they have traditions like we have traditions, Michael.
Yeah.
You know, we have traditions that are wrong, clearly wrong, but yet people do them. Hey, it's Easter Sunday today here in America. This is Sunday, the 12th of April. And you couldn't get more trouble than mixing the holy with the profane. And Easter is a great example, isn't it, Michael?
Yes, I just received an SMS message from a colleague of mine. Oh, happy Easter and stay healthy.
Oh, no. yeah, well, best thing you can do is wish him a happy Easter as well. But later you can confront him with the facts. And that's the thing. We got to be slow with people that are ignorant, because we were ignorant too, Michael. And, you know, it's okay to react the way you need to react, of course. But I mean, I just hope that there's going to be enough time for people to come to the knowledge of the historical truth, because really this is the grander lesson in life, the Bible and history. History is very important because it shows us the providence of God. And I know that's a tough one. It's a tough one for me. It's a tough one for all of us. But now is the time. Now is the time to research. Now is the time to study. And now is the time to know that we need to repent in every way we can and not paint our faces like Gene Simmons and go around on stages and promote the power of money or whatever. It's the wrong way. That's the way of the world. That's the way of pride. That's the way of Satan. And that's all we got today on this session. So we're looking forward to catching up with you next time. And please don't forget to read your Bible and study with your friends and family and those whom you love, because the time is at hand. Maranatha.